One of the greatest songs in the world ever written was by Freddie Mercury. And Freddie Mercury's connection to this song is a very, very powerful thing that I want to discuss after we've heard this young man, Gregory LeMarshal, who died of cystic fibrosis. But during his fame, and he was very famous in France, he was like the most popular star. And you know, you think of Justin Bieber today, he's probably be his legacy will always live on in the heads of those that grew up with him. And since he died, remember him in France. He's just one of those compelling stars who suffered tremendously and yet went on stage with a lung disorder, with a disease fighting at his lung, his breathing, and performed and performed and performed until the bitter end. And it's because of his strength and his inspiration that I want to do this video in memory of Gregory LeMarshal and not forget his memory. Attached to this video in the description is a link to SOS, one of his biggest songs and one of his most popular songs. And it is sung by the wonderful Dimash. Now I want you to listen. Dimash was singing it for his friend, but I have incorporated Gregory into that because when I read his story and SOS, I linked Dimash with him, not Dimash with his friend. So I want to make that very, very clear. Now, come back to this song. I'm not going to analyze the lyrics, but it is in 16 languages. So check your subtitles for this whole video and the lyrics to the song. I just want us to remember the memory of Gregory LeMarshal and his fight, his very sad fight for a disease that so many people suffer from. And it's not as well known as cancer, but thousands of people suffer it throughout the world. Gregory John Paul LeMarchal, Jean Paul, known professionally as Gregory LeMarchal, was a French singer who rose to fame by winning the fourth series of the reality television show Star Academy, which was broadcast on TF1. He died at the age of 23 of health complications, cystic fibrosis, while waiting in hospital for a lung transplant. Imagine, so close. A posthumous album, Le Voix Son Ange, was released with profits going towards the Association Gregory LeMarshal Charity, set up by his family after his death. A compilation, Reves, was released in 2009, and to date, he's still selling, has sold more than 2 million albums. I want to play this in memory of a guy that fought valiantly, that was so popular in France. I don't want his memory on my channel to fade, because when I heard the SOS version, I connected it to Dimash because he was singing SOS. And I just thought it'd be a nice combination, two fantastic singers, lots of similarities, and I made a video. But this is my single video to all those fighting diseases like cystic fibrosis. If you are, I dedicate Gregory LeMarshal. He was just weeks away from a lung transplant that could have saved his life, transformed his, and he would still be here. But complications arose and he died. So close, so far away. I leave you the links to his channel, his music, his memory, his legacy, everything in the description. But for now, if you are battling something that is really, really difficult, take inspiration from a young man that had everything to live for, was so close to continuing to live, but it was snatched away from him. But just don't give up hope. If you're in a situation that you need inspiration for, just remember, the show must go on. And I leave you with Gregory LeMarshal, and I will come back after just to give you Freddie Mercury's parallel to Gregory LeMarshal's situation. And that's all I'm going to do, and then I'm just going to leave it. But let's hear Gregory LeMarshal singing a fantastic version a Freddie Mercury song. The show must go on. Because for Gregory, right up until the end, it was. So don't give up hope.
Empty spaces, what are we living for? Abandoned places, I guess we know this code. On and on, does anybody know what we are looking for? Another hero, another mind is crying behind the curtain in the pantomime. It anymore. The show must go on. The show must go on. Yeah. Ooh, inside my heart is breaking. My makeup may be flaking, but my smile still stays on.
That doesn't inspire you, I don't know what would. He was standing on stage with cystic fibrosis running through his lungs and intestine. The pain he would have been in, but he didn't display it. He just went on and performed because in his mind, the show must go on. I must fight this. I must get up. It's such an inspiration, this young man. It's such an inspirational song that he sang that it's at parallel level. And I'll just finish it with why it's at parallel level. I'm actually quite emotional. The song is about truly a fantastic Queen song recorded while Freddie Mercury was battling his symptoms from HIV and AIDS. That's the parallel. Freddie was also battling with his disease. And The Show Must Go On is a compelling, powerful, final coda to Freddie's legacy. The song closes Queen's final studio album released during Freddie's lifetime. And while The Show Must Go On was mainly written by lead guitarist Brian May, the song's theme is driven by the probability it would be Freddie Mercury's finale. His severe symptoms made recording innuendo difficult. Freddie's struggle with HIV/AIDS were kept secret from the public at large until his official 1991, November the 23rd press release, divulging that he was in fact dying from AIDS-related complications. Previously, the British paparazzi had speculated cruelly and reported that Freddie was diagnosed with the disease from the time his diagnosis was leaked and proceeded to stalk him, adding insult to injury. Intentionally or not, Freddie's announcing his illness on the 23rd of November was prescient, because approximately 24 hours after the press release, Freddie Mercury died. And that is where the parallel comes in. There's a man that died 24 hours after releasing his press release of his illness. And this is a young man that died waiting on a lung transplant. But both of them had the one thing in common: the show must go on. And that is why I played it today, because I think in all our situations, our difficult situations, we must learn from this. And may for all of us, health, mental, physical, monetary, finances, may the show go on for a successful conclusion, but may you be inspired by the great Freddie and the wonderful Gregory LeMarshal, who both had a common bond that they believed they will carry on to the end, until the end.